Have you ever cranked up your 3D printer's speed setting in hopes of completing your prints faster, only to find that you are still hitting a speed limit? In this video, we'll uncover the reasons behind this limitation. The key to fast printing lies in understanding the dynamic interplay between your hot end and extruder. These components determine how quickly filament can be fed into the nozzle and how efficiently it can be melted for extrusion. Essentially, it boils down to one crucial matrix, that is the maximum volumetric speed. But what exactly is maximum volumetric speed? It's the rate at which your 3D printer can extrude plastic through the nozzle per second. In simple terms, it's a measure of how much material you can push out of the nozzle in a given amount of time. Join us as we explore the intricacies of max volumetric speed and unravel the factors that influence its limitation. For the capabilities of the hot end to the efficiency of your extruder, we'll delve into the critical component that determine your printer's speed potential. So buckle up and get ready to unlock the secret of 3D printing. By the end of this video, you all will have a deeper understanding of why speed isn't just about pushing the limits, it's about mastering the balance between performance and precision. Max volumetric speed setting is at the filament level, and we can find it in the filament profile. So this is the filament profile. Click this button, filament, and over here you will see max volumetric speed. Else you can click this search button and type max and select this one, max volumetric speed. This will take you directly at this particular parameter. Max volumetric speed also depends on the nozzle size. That is, different nozzle size will require different volumetric speed. Most of the printers are equipped with 0.4 mm nozzle, and my test is also based on a 0.4 mm nozzle. Before we proceed with the max volumetric speed test, ensure that the line width is the same size as the nozzle. So what you see over here is 0.4, that is the size of the nozzle. Please ensure that this value is same to the same size of the nozzle. A value less than that might not be able to proceed with the test, or you might not get the correct test result. Printing speed not only depends on the printer but also the object we are printing. If the object has too many corners, then that could also slow down the print. It also depends on number of wall loops, top shell layers, bottom shell layers, spare infill density, acceleration, and of course the speed setting. But the main limiting factor which actually calculates the printing speed is the max volumetric speed. There are three main factors to understand in tuning max volumetric speed. First, it depends on the type and the brand of the filament. Second, the torque of the extruder, that is the force required as to how fast it can push the filament into the hot end. And third, the type of the hot end, that is how fast it can melt the given amount of filament by the extruder. If the extruder pushes too fast above the melting capacity of the hot end, it can cause filament grinding, which will lead to print failures. Most of modern hot ends are capable of handling the max volumetric speed greater than 10 cubic millimeter per second. We can determine the maximum printing speed for any of these values over here if we know our max volumetric speed for a given hot end. So let's say if the hot end is capable of 20 cubic millimeters per second, then we can calculate the speed that we can set over here. So let's say our hot end is capable of 20 cubic millimeters per second. So 20 divided by the nozzle size, that is 0.4, divided by the layer height. So let's say our layer height is 0.2. So this will be the maximum speed that we can set in our printer profile. So over here we can set to 250, provided our hot end is capable of 20 cubic millimeters per second as a volumetric speed. What will happen if we set the printing speed above the calculated value? So in this case, it is 250. And if we set over here, if you see inner wall is 300. In this case, the speed will be limited by the max volumetric speed. It will come close to 250. It will be slight more than that, but it will never be at this speed. One way to achieve maximum speed is by setting a value higher than what is being actually calculated. So over here, the calculated value is 250. We can set over here under the other layer speed, we can set this value to more than 250. That way, the slicer will calculate the maximum speed based on the max volumetric speed. But that's, again, it's your choice whether you want to set it that way or no. Depends on the quality of the print that you want to achieve. Going faster always may not be necessary. It may output in a bad quality print, especially for the outer wall. Now let's analyze by changing the max volumetric speed and see if we can achieve fast printing. So this is a sample test print where it has two walls over here, top shell layers 2, bottom shell layers 2, and spare infill density 15. And our max volumetric speed is set to 12, which is 12 cubic millimeters per second. So we'll slice this model. And over here, if you see, total time 4 hours 10 minutes. The infill density, which is 15%, and a total time of 4 hours 10 minutes. Now let's change the max volumetric speed. I'll click here. Over here, we'll change this max volumetric speed, let's say 20. This is just a random number, I have not yet calculated yet. So we'll set it to 20 and see whether we can achieve or no. We'll slice the model. And now if you see, the total time is 3 hours 4 minutes. Now if you see here with the max volumetric set to 20, it takes 3 hours 4 minutes. Whereas in the previous case where max volumetric speed was set to 12, it would take 4 hours 10 minutes. So approximately 1 hour print time is less. But please note, even though it says over here 3 hours 4 minutes, it actually depends on your printer configuration. Your actual printer might be little inefficient. It might take little more time compared to the values what we have set here. So now we have understood the importance of max volumetric speed. Let's see how we can tune this value. Click on the calibration button over here, then click on more and max flow rate. We'll be presented with this pop-up window where these are the default values. So start volumetric speed 5, end volumetric speed 20, and step 0.5. So start value is where you will start the calculation of the max volumetric, and it will end at maximum of 20 volumetric speed, 20 cubic mm volumetric speed. So, and steps is the incremental steps from 5 to 20, how much of increment must be done, that will be determined by this value. It will increment here at 0.5 cubic millimeter per second. Starting at 5 is okay, but we know that any modern hot end are quite capable of at a volumetric speed of 10. So we'll start at 10. If you know that your hot end is capable of more than 20 over here, so let's say your hot end says it can do at 30 cubic millimeter per second, then you can start here with, let's say, 15 and then 30 over here like this. So you can determine what is the best volumetric speed, or you can even go more than that, let's say 40, and find out what is the maximum max volumetric speed that you can go. So mine, I'm using Sprite Extruder. I exactly don't know what is the maximum max volumetric speed it can do, but 20 I will set over here, and I will start with 10, and increment I will leave it as 0.5. click OK. No other changes to be done over here, just ignore this warning. You can directly go and slice, but let's understand few parameters that are very important to know. First is layer height. This layer height must be during the test result, to maximize the flow, we need to set this value to 80% of the nozzle size. So minus 0.4, the nozzle diameter of that 80% is 0.32, and the outer wall must be greater than the nozzle size. If because we are doing only one wall, and if you set this to 0.4, the wall will become very flimsy. It will have difficulty in laying layers on top of each other. That is why you have to have a thick wall. A combination of this helps in pushing more amount, more and more filament out of the nozzle, where it helps in calculating the maximum max volumetric speed. So now we'll slice this model. Now if you see over here, there are some lines. So these are the guidelines where we'll use these lines to calculate the maximum max volumetric speed. We can also use a caliper or a ruler to measure. So in that case, we'll have to measure the height and then do the calculation. But I will stick to this guideline because it is very easy to determine the max volumetric speed. So over here, we can slide it down little bit and slide this value as well. So here, if you see it over here, it shows that the flow is set to 19.85. So this value we will set as max volumetric speed, which is over here. Max volumetric speed over here, we are going to set this value after we know the best value by doing the test print. Now let's analyze this test print. Look all around the test print, and you will see the similar artifacts. What you see over here and down, you will see the same all around the test print. So I will focus on this side of the test print where we have this guideline. Let's zoom in and see. So we'll start from bottom. So we have this marker, which I have highlighted here, is guideline. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So if you look here, until 7, we have a good quality test print, except the these marker lines, this line and this line. If you compare to this other line, they are not good. But for calculating the max volumetric speed, we'll focus until here. So until 7. So from here, we need to go back to the slicer and see at this level, what is the flow set. So from there, we will take the lowest value without any decimal. So we'll go to the slicer now and see at this level, what is the speed, the flow set. Now we are at the slicer. We need to find out the flow set at this particular layer over here, the seventh guideline. So from bottom, we'll find out the seventh guideline. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now make sure our color scheme, if you see here, this should be flow. Okay, default will be layer type. You have to select flow. Once you have this, you will get this flow value over here. So this is the value that we need to set in the slicer without any decimal. 16. So here the value is 16. So we'll set in the slicer the printer profile, the filament profile over here, max volumetric speed. This should be set as 16. And if the max volumetric speed is set too high, this will be the output. Thank you for joining us on this journey to understand and optimize the maximum volumetric speed of your 3D printer. I trust you found this information helpful in tuning the settings for efficiency and quality. Don't hesitate to share your feedback in the comment below. I am Remy, and I'll catch you in the next video. Until then, happy printing.